Hi guys, welcome to Manuver. In this session, I'll discuss about the MBA CET 2018, especially the quant section. Alright, so 50 marks paper is of your quant. So total CET is for 200 marks, and out of that quant section is 50, which is nothing but 1/4 of the paper is your quant. Alright, and to solve 200 questions, you have 150 minutes. Alright. So basically, this video is especially about the why people get end up with a bad score in quant. Okay, if I compare 2016, 2017 paper and 2018, we don't know as of now. All right. So 2017 paper was slightly more higher than the 2016 one. Okay. So those ask your friend who have written the 2017 CET paper. They will tell you better. Okay, how's the paper was. People had well prepared for the CET. They were pretty much confident about their preparation, and that they were pretty much sure that they will score good marks. But the moment they seen the paper, so paper was like a surprise for them. The paper was lengthy, time consuming, alright, and the difficulty level was slightly higher. So this is what the people have faced in 2017. Alright, so we will definitely speculate in the same type of the paper in 2018. Alright, so I'll give the 10 reasons why people end up with the bad score, especially in the quant section. Alright, so these are the main reasons, guys, why people end up with the bad score. The length of the question was higher, very high, and people bore to read, or sometime it happened like they forget the formula. Because in quant we try to solve 70 to 80% of the question without formula, but 20% of the question you need somewhere formula. So this is what the problem. Time consuming question were the very time consuming, lengthy and time consuming. This is what the problem, because CET have just 150 minutes and 200 questions. Out of that, even not a one question, 1 minute. So you cannot dedicate 1 minute even to one question. That's a problem. And if the question become very lengthy, and so it will be difficult for us to in 1 minute even solve one question. So this is what happened in the CET 2017. And those who had well planned for the time management, this idea got flopped. Time management. Then they started the pan. Then panic gets you start panicking, and then you lose your confidence. Then you mark randomly, because CET have no negative marking, as we all know. Then mark randomly, and at the end you start thinking of this in the exam hall itself. You start thinking of, okay, this is not the cup of tea for this year CET. Let's try for next year. This is what the usually happen with the student, and then you give up. This is what the major reason for the student who haven't scored good marks in the CET 2017. Okay, ask your friend, those who have written the 2017 paper. They will tell you better than me. Alright, so these are the points which you have to keep in mind in your 2018 preparation planning, especially for the quant. Alright, because it is unlike the 2014 paper. If you pick the 2014 papers of CET, it is like a cakewalk sort of a paper. If you compare 2014 paper with 2017 paper of CET, then you will easily get to know, okay, 2014 paper was pretty much easier than the 2017 one. So that's a reason, and so you have to well prepare for 2018. All right, CET, considering the difficulty part and all these points. Fine, so quickly let's see the paper pattern of the quant section. So quant overall 20 to 30 marks paper you can expect. DIDS, data interpretation, data sufficiency and data comparison, 20 to 25 marks it keep on vary. Okay, so this is what a roughly break even I have picked. Board mass is not coming since last 2 years, guys, so still lots of the institute are saying that board mass come for 10 marks, but it is not so. 2017 there was no board mass, 2016 no board mass, only the statement level questions, word problem. All right, so percentage, SICI, profit and loss, average, ratio proportion, mixture allocation, time and work, 2 questions, time and speed, 2 questions, geometry is important, okay, 3 to 4 questions, then trig probability, modern maths, and then your algebra part, 5 to 6 questions. So this is what a roughly break even of the your con section. Table, bar chart, line chart, pie chart, caselet, and data sufficiency and data comparison. So these are the, so including cont. In cont, especially there are four sections. One is your con section, then your there is a data interpretation section, then there is a data sufficiency, then there is a data comparison. So especially it is segregated into the four section, and that including that there is a con section which is for the 50 marks. So just be prepared with all these topic guys well and thorough, and with the higher difficulty level, and how you can manage the time also. So overall it is 50 marks paper. All right, this is what the example which I have picked of. So just give the feel of the how the questions they ask in the exam. So let's try, and every question I can beat you 20 to 30 seconds, not more than that. Okay, so if I read this question, if x is a positive natural number, which of the following is greatest? Alright, before you start solving the question guys, first your concept has to be very good. So first you should understand what is the positive. Positive means plus sign. What is a natural number? So we all know and we should know that natural number start from 1 to positive infinity. If you don't know this, then there is a problem. And it is asking the greatest number. So the value which I should keep in the option, it should be smaller. It should be. So least value, which is the natural number is, and which is positive as well, is 1. So just substitute 1, start substituting the 1 here. This is nothing but 2 by 3, which is your 66.66. This is nothing but your 6, and this is nothing but 2, which is nothing but 3, and this is nothing but 1, and this is nothing but 6, and what about this? This is 4, and this is nothing but 2. So this is your 2. Alright, so which one is the greatest guys? Obviously not this, obviously this, not this, and not this. Alright, so if your concept is thorough, so you can easily manage the question within 20 to 30 seconds. Okay, so we'll discuss about the strategy part also, and what are the shortcuts which we will use in my later videos. If you are a part of the manure student, if you are part of the online or the offline classroom student, so obviously you will be getting the benefit of this. Okay, fine, let's go to the next question. Example number 2, the average age of A, B and C is 27 years. All right, if the average age of A and B is 25 years, all right, what is the age of C? I can challenge you, most of the students solve this question by this method. A by B, A plus B plus C divide by 3 is 27, and A plus B divide by 2 is 25. So A plus B plus C is nothing but 81, and A plus B is nothing but 50. So they will do 80 minus 50, which is nothing but 31. So 4th is your answer. But you don't have to do all these things guys. For me, it is a matter of 10 seconds. It is a matter of 10 seconds. Believe me, 10 seconds, you can nail this question. 5 seconds, you need to read this question. You need 5 seconds to read this question well and to understand, let's say two seconds more. In next 3 seconds, you end up with the answer. If you see, average of ABC is 27 years. Okay, so A plus B plus C, this is 27 is given. And the average age of A and B is given to you, which is nothing but 25. Your average is going down by 2 from here to here when A and B are coming out. So two people are coming out and average is going by 2, so which is nothing but 4. So just add 27 plus 4 is nothing but 31. This is your answer. You don't have to do all this calculation. Stop doing the more of rough work. Just depend on your mental calculation, that will be more better if you really want to score good marks in CET. Because CET is the sort of exam where you need more of speed with the good accuracy. All right. Okay, looking this question, it seems like it will take more than 1 or 2 minutes. But for me, it is a matter of 30 seconds. All right. So reading the question will take 10 seconds. If you read the question, Suresh had 3 books PQR. Of these, P had 150 pages. Q had 20% more pages than P, and R had 20% less than P. Okay, if they remove, he removed 10%, 5% and 15% page from PQR respectively, then what percent of the total page did he tear? So PQR is there. All right, So if you consider 150, your calculation will be slightly tougher. So let's forget about the 150, let's say it is 100. If this is 100, so saying Q had 20% more, which is nothing but 120, and QR is 20% less, which is nothing but 180, this is 80. So total is nothing but 300, all right? And from here, he is removing 10% from here, 5% from here, and 15% from here, all right? So you left with 90 because you removed 10 here, and you 5% is nothing but you remove 6 here, so this will be nothing but 114, all right? And from here you are removing 15%, all right? So 10% is your 8, and 5% is your 4. 12 you are removing from here, minus 12, right? So you end up with here 68, all right? So 80 minus 12 is nothing but your 68. So now the question is, what the percentage of the total page did he remove? So he removed total how much pages? 6. How many pages? 10, 6, and 12. 12 plus 6 is 18, plus 10 is 28 out of 300. So this is nothing but you just have to divide 28 by 3, which is 9 point something. See, this is out and this is out. You'll end up with just two options, but it will be 9.3333. So just B is your answer. See, I haven't considered the 150 here. If I would have considered 150, my calculation will be slightly tougher. So 100 is the very good number to start with this question. So all these sort of type of the tricks we'll discuss in my short. I have discussed in my shortcut workshop also. All right. So yeah. So how your preparation should be for the exam? Okay. So you should be done with your basic first, then level one questions. All right, and then immediately jump to the shortcut for the level one, and then give the sectional test, which is very, very important. And it will tell you where you stand and how much preparation you have done and how much more is required to you. Then jump to the level two questions. All right, then actual pick the actual CET questions, then shortcut on it, and then give the plethora of mock test, and then solve the past year paper. I can bet you will be end up with the 100% positive score. That is with the promise. All right. Fine. So this is what the basically the our preparation planning. We do the basic level one shortcut, then sectional test, and level two. So if you are a part of the manu, if you are a manual student, so you will be getting the benefit of this and as well as the shortcut video lectures too. All right. If you want to be part of the online program or the classroom program, guys, you can call on 8828581455 or 8828581454, all right, to get the information about the courses or the any query regarding the CET you have. You can ping, you can call us, or you can ping me on facebook.com manuver, manoeuvre, all right. This is the spelling, all right. And please do subscribe the channel if you want to see more videos and update regarding the CET, all right. And for more information, you can visit manuveredu.com. All the best for your CET 2018 preparation, guys. Thank you.